I saw Reggie Watts perform this and got really inspired. But then also got discouraged because I don't have looping tools and hardware. And so after I seen that, I said, oh, I need to go look into one of these. And then I said, no, I don't. I've got Reaper, and I've got my keyboard, and I've got my basic little Korg Nano keys right here, inexpensive little MIDI controller. So with that and some hotkeys right here, which I set up in Reaper under Actions, Show Action List, and you can literally just type in what you want to look for and add a hotkey for it. So up and down keys navigate my track, caps lock, arms and disarms, tracks, number lock, arms, and disarms the metronome. I can select different tracks by pressing up and down, and when I get the track I want, press caps lock to arm it. Then I can play that track. So let's start with the drums. Arm it, I'm gonna hit metronome, and we're gonna roll with it. We got a tempo, control R to record. Disable the metronome. Come down to the bass. All right, disarm the bass, arm the synth, and play something else. All right, let's come down to the solo, and I'm going to arm it, but I'm going to press Control R to take it off of record mode, and now we should be able to just play around and have fun. Something like that right there. Very fun. All right, and so one little thing you might have noticed and that slipped in, I pressed R, and that toggles the loop. All right, so, and you may not like my high keys, but set it up how you like. Preferentially, you want to get you a MIDI controller and assign all this to the same controller that you play a note on. That would be the bomb diggity right there. And if your timing ain't exactly right like Craftsman's, come over here to Quantization. Yeah, baby, that right there now, what that's going to do is snap your notes exactly where they need to be. A very important thing to point out too is we want to pay attention to how your MIDI is recording. I like to use Overdub, and that allows you to do things like this. We armed. Once we feel like we got the beat, we can Control R, in my case, and start recording. All right. Now we don't need the metronome. And now we could just do the bass. And the snare. And we might add something else too. Let's see if I can do it right. There we go. But yeah, you can build things up just a little bit at a time, you know, as you feel comfortable. So coming back to MIDI instruments, if you don't even have like a little cheap, you know, controller like I got right here, you can just use Imatone like I showed in the previous video. And hum notes, or even configure it so you can beatbox. All right, so we've got a blank project, and I want to show you that you don't have to use synthetic, you know, MIDI samples and things like that, instruments. You can come here and just new track. And in my case, I'm just going to use my regular input on my focus right, Scarlett 2i2. That's weird when you hear yourself twice like that. We got a new track, and I'm going to actually just use my microphone and my little baritone ukulele. And we're going to play, I call this the Steady Crafting theme song. It goes from an A to an E to a D7. And then from an A to an E to a D major. That's it, AED7, AED major. I know that this song is 110 beats per minute. If you don't know the tempo, you can actually use a tap tempo feature. That means you just tap along while the music's playing, da, 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 and it'll tell you what the tempo is. In my case, I know it's 110, and I know I'm gonna want a battle. Let's see, 1, 2, 3. Let me see. So we're gonna need some more room than that, I just found out. So we're gonna bring it out this way. What I'm gonna do a little different here is I'm actually gonna come down to count in before recording. And what that's going to do is we hit record, it's gonna go tick, tick, tick before it ever starts. That way it gives you a little chance to get ready. Let's roll with it.
2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4.
Now, just a quick note, you noticed that it started to do that little record extra. That's because I got it in loop mode, and if you wanted to, it will keep recording multiple takes, and they'll just stack up on you, and you can select the one that you want and then crop to active take using that right there that would normally be active, see? But Reaper has a pretty slick option that keeps you from having partial recordings, like when it's just hanging over from the end of your loop and it comes in. So, options, preferences. And we're going to come down here to loop lane recording. And check this out right here. So this is a pretty handy feature that will eliminate partial loops for you automatically. And you can even set a threshold right there. Pretty neat. All right, probably not my best recording. As you can see, you normally want to see more amplitude, more spikes coming up in here. Okay, so I'm gonna add another track, arm it for recording. And let's find something. Like plastic egg filled with some rice right here. Bring in another track, and let's see, let's start naming some things here. That's the uke. Let's add a tambourine. Bring another layer, but let's bring in a virtual instrument. right, so I've said it many times on the program, Craftman is not a musician. What I do is I just listen to things and then try to match it up with my ear. That's simple as that. So I'm going to disable actually record. I'm going to keep this instrument armed. Let's go ahead and call it something. I like to just call it solo. All right. And we're just going to roll with it and have fun. So all I'm doing is just bouncing around. I'm listening. I'm saying, okay, I know. So with these three notes right here, we can just, you can make it a melody just with those three. But I know I want to go, ooh, just something in the song makes me want to go higher. Sorry about that, but look. This is as much music theory as I know. You find where the sound kind of lives. See how that note just kind of, it kind of feels like it wants to, that's where it kind of wants to pull back to. So if I go here, back to that, it's going to sound right. If I also go, I don't really know music theory. That's just how I make melodies. This is a magnet. There's a magnet pulling me back. Whether I go, sorry, I'm not trying to get off into music theory that I don't understand. I'm just telling you, I literally would just try to remember, okay, I can play these notes. Let's solo with those notes. So eventually I came up with something about like this. The idea I want to get across is just to play, to have fun, to not freeze up. Magical things happen right here in this loop. And by the way, I just want to say again, I've got an entire video about virtual instruments and MIDI and how all this stuff works together. Hopefully this video inspired you. And I want to say, Reaper is free or can be purchased at a low price. And as far as plugins for virtual instruments, look at this. All day long, you can find free ones on the internet. And lastly, if you don't even have a MIDI keyboard, you don't need one. Just use your keyboard. Here's Candid Joy showing you right here how you can do that in Reaper. Pretty fantastic. Tons of possibilities with this, ladies and gentlemen. Don't be afraid to hit the wrong note. Have fun with it. Until next time, I love y'all and keep on steady crafting. We might could try this harmonica right here. It's a bass harmonica. Yeah. Thank you. That's pretty fun to play with right there. Thank you to my buddy Jose Chambrot for that.